Hello and welcome to our presentation of Kernel Helm and VDEV. In this video, we demonstrate how to reverse engineer feature dependencies from code files using Kernel Helm. Kernel Helm is an experimentation workbench to conduct different analysis. Kernel Helm is realized as a fast command line tool that produces different analysis results. The analysis or visualization of these results are not the objective of Kernel Helm. For this, we use the feature dependency visualization tool, shortly VDEV, developed by ScopeSet. VDEV visualizes the results of KernelHelm in a graph and allows browsing of extraction results. Further, we analyze whether extracted dependencies are consistent to the architecture of the analyzed product line. For the demonstration, we use Linux 4.14. The dependency extraction is based on the feature effect analysis approach as published by Zarinadi et al. First, we gather all presence conditions from all code artifacts. This includes code files, but also make scripts. Next, we compute for each feature how the resulting product will change if the feature is selected or deselected. For this, we take all conditions where the feature is involved in and select and deselect that feature. Both versions of the condition are combined via an XOR. The XOR constraints are combined via a disjunction. The resulting constraint does not contain the selected feature anymore and can be interpreted as a precondition when the selection of the feature has an impact to the product derivation. Here we demonstrate how the approach works. For this, we want to compute the precondition for the selection of feature A. Feature A appears only nested inside another feature B. As a result, we obtain the presence condition A and B. In this formula, we set A to true and A to false and combine both versions with an XOR. The resulting formula contains only B and shows that A has only an effect if B was selected before. That's because A is nested inside a preprocessor block, which is controlled by B. In a second file, A is nested inside C. We obtain the presence condition A and C. Again, we select A to true and A to false, combine both conditions via an XOR, and create a disjunction with the previous condition. As a result, we see that A has only an effect on the product derivation if B or C were selected before. Finally, we find another code file where A is not nested inside any other condition. If we update the feature effect constraint, we see that A has always an impact to the product derivation. Before we start with the demonstration, we need an understanding of Kernel Helm. Kernel Helm is designed to extract variability information from different information sources. This happens in parallel processing pipelines. Based on this information, Kernel Helm provides support for various analysis. The information extraction can be realized with different extractors. These extractors may be exchanged or disabled according to the analysis requirements or to the artifact types. The information is stored in data models which serve as an input for the desired analysis. Kernel Helm stores its result in different table-based formats. An important aspect of Kernel Helm is that it allows the configuration of the extraction, the analysis, and the output format. Okay, let's start with the presentation of Kernel Helm. First, we need to download and unpack Kernel Helm. Next, we need a system to analyze. For this, we download and unpack Linux 4.14 from kernel.org. Please note that some of the provided extractors run only on Linux and work with Linux up to version 4.17. Kernel Helm is shipped with a configuration file to extract code dependencies from Linux. We need only to specify the location of the measured system. However, we also specify Excel workbooks as output format and add a parameter to save intermediate results into a separate sheet of the workbook. When we are finished, we can start the analysis. For this, we need to start Kernel Helm and pass the configuration file as first parameter. Kernel Helm starts the extraction pipelines to gather all presence conditions from code and make files. Please note that the heuristic approach of makefile extractor throws some warnings for code files which could not be found in the make scripts. These warnings can be ignored in our case. The analysis starts after the last extraction pipeline has been finished. Kernel Helm requires around 5 minutes to analyze the complete source code of Linux. When Kernel Helm has finished its analysis, it writes a 1.3 MB large Excel file into its output folder. The workbook contains two sheets since we enabled writing of intermediate results. The first sheet contains always the results of the specified analysis, while the other sheets contain intermediate results of the previous analysis steps. The feature effect sheet contains two columns. The first column lists all features of the variability model, which we could also find in code and makefiles. The second column contains a computed precondition under which situation the selection of the feature of the first column has an effect. The one represents true, meaning the selection of the feature has always an effect on the product derivation. For instance, feature config 64-bit has always an effect on the product derivation. Another example is the feature config ATH10K, which is used to configure drivers for Wi-Fi chips developed by Qualcomm Atheros. Here we see that enabling this feature has only an effect if at least also the feature of the vendor, config WirusLAN vendor ATH, and the general support for wireless network, config VLAN, have been enabled. The cheat presence conditions contain the information of the data collection phase and may be used to trace and understand the analysis results. This list is not limited to features only and contains a list of all discovered preprocessor symbols. For all symbols, we see the presence conditions where they are used in. This information is stored in a comma-separated list and may be used to trace the results of the previous cheat. The analysis of table-based data may become very complex. For this task, we realized together with ScopeSet a graph-based alternative to analyze implemented dependencies. The revamp release of Kernelhaven includes an alternative configuration file, which we use for this task. The main differences of the configuration file compared with the previously used one are the following changed parameters. First, we use the architectural dependency visualization instead of the modeled analysis pipeline. This analysis estimates architectural responsibilities of features based on the file system location where are they defined. However, this requires that the variability model extractor collects this information. Further, we store the analysis result in an SQL Lite database instead of the Excel file, which serves as an interface to the VDEV tool. When we start Kernelhaven with these parameters, we obtain after 5 minutes a 180 MB SQL archive for the visualization of dependencies with the VDEV tool. VDEV visualizes the results of two revamp tools, Kernelhaven and Vexa. This presentation shows how to visualize the results of Kernelhaven. For this, we open the generated SQLite database and two empty Excel files in VDEV. Data generated by VDEV will be saved into these Excel documents. On the left side, we get a list of architectural components discovered by Kernelhaven. In the case of Linux, we use the location of the source tree of the feature definition to determine whether the feature is related to the CPU architecture, drivers, network stack, and so on. Below, we see a small window showing some statistics and which we use later in this presentation for searching. In the bottom, we have some tables showing the analyzed data of Kernelhaven. The most important tables are the list of features and their computed feature effect constraints, a tabular representation of dependency structure, which we demonstrate next, the list of features and their relation to architectural components. This is comparable to the list on the left side, a tabular representation of dependencies among architectural components, and finally a list of architectural components and the numbers of features belonging to the component. Further, we have two views for browsing the data. One view for browsing through the architectural components and one view for browsing through the dependencies among features. Okay, let's start with the analysis of feature dependencies. For this, we search for the feature config underscore ATH10K, which we have already analyzed via the Excel output of Kernelhaven. The result is a single node of a graph representing the searched feature. The first line shows the name of the feature, the second line its precondition. In and out show the number of incoming connections that are features that use config ATH10K in their precondition, and the number of outgoing connections that are features that are used in the precondition of config underscore ATH10K. The yellow circle denotes that we found an architectural component to which the feature belongs to. Here we see that config underscore ATH10K belongs to the network driver. Via the context menu, we can save a node, which will be stored in the previously specified Excel documents. Here we store the results of a manual analysis that the feature represents a driver of the Atheros Wi-Fi chipset. Now we want to see all features that are dependent on the displayed feature. Through the selection of load incoming dependencies, we see all 14 features make use of the config underscore ath10k in the precondition. The different colors of the arrows indicate whether there is a requires, an excludes, or some other kind of relationship, like for example any of. Further, the arrows are labeled with a subformula of the condition, showing what else has to be fulfilled after the target feature has been selected. For instance, the selection of config underscore ath10k underscore tracing requires the selection of config underscore ath10k or, indicated by the black arrow, the selection of config underscore vendor underscore ath and config underscore virus-lan. Next, we mark all features and select show hide parent submodule to switch over to an architectural view on the dependencies. FIDEF presents now the involved architectural components, and we can see that the network drivers are related to driver-independent wireless network stack and the thermal component. The latter serves as an interface to measure the temperature of hardware components. This structure seems reasonable from an architectural viewpoint. Finally, we start a second analysis based on architectural components. For this, we clear the view and select block component, which is required to support block devices. We select Show Submodule Architectural Context to detect other components that are related to the block component. As a result, we see that elements of the kernel initialization, the file system, partitions, or device drivers are related to the block device, which looks also very reasonable. Our presentation on reverse engineering of feature dependencies with Kernelhaven and FIDEF is over now. You can download bundled versions of Kernelhaven as well as the source code of Kernelhaven and its publicly available plugins from our GitHub site. If you have any questions regarding the concepts or the application of Kernelhaven, then please do not hesitate to contact either Sascha El-Chakavi or Klaus Schmidt. The feature dependency visualization tool FIDEF, which we use to visualize the results of Kernelhaven, was developed by ScopeSet. You can download FIDEF from ScopeForge. For questions related to the tool or to the visualization, please contact Michael Benkel or Felix Ruder. We hope you enjoyed the presentation.